I thought I knew everything there was to know about After Effects. I was wrong. These techniques have never been exposed, never seen sunlight, and never known what it's like to feel joy. Until now. One, if you need to select all but a few layers, you can select only the layers you don't need, and then right-click, choose Invert Layer Selection to get only the layers you want. Two, while making a mask, type the first letter of any of the mask modes to switch to that mode. Here I'm making a mask on a solid, which by default uses the Add Mask mode, but if I type S, now it uses the mode Subtract. Now if I select a point and type A while dragging it around, we're back to the Add mode. And this works for all the modes. N for None, A for Add, S for Subtract, I for Intersect, L for Lighten, D for Darken, and F for Difference. Difference. Three, while creating a shape with the Shape tool, hold Spacebar to reposition it. Four, in the Expression Editor, hold Ctrl or Command and scroll up on the mouse wheel to enlarge the text. But be warned, as soon as you click away, the text will return to normal size. Oh. 5. Several of the transform properties can be quickly reset by double-clicking tools. The selection tool resets scale, the rotation tool resets rotation, and the pan behind resets the anchor point. 6. If you push and hold the shortcut key for a tool, in this case W for rotation, when the key is released, the previously used tool will be active again. 7. If you have a complex rig with lots of parented layers and need to select all the children of a specific layer, just right-click on the layer and choose Select Children from the context menu. Now this is where I would normally promote my animation course, Master Motion Design, but I want to keep this video quick. So there's just no time to explain how it was built from the ground up to help take your motion to the next level with a bunch of amazing practical projects, and not nearly enough time to show the amazing student work that is coming out of these assignments, so I'm afraid you're just gonna have to imagine that I've done that. But imagine it convincingly, very convincingly. Alright, next tip. 8. Shift plus pick whip one layer to another to parent it and apply the parent's position, scale, rotation, and anchor point to the child. Now note, this doesn't impact opacity. Also, because the layer is now parented, the position and anchor point values will be adjusted so the child sits exactly in the same spot in the composition panel. 9. To remove all the effects from one or multiple layers, simply select them and execute the shortcut Ctrl or Command plus Shift and E. You can also use the menu option Effect and Remove All, but ain't nobody got time for that. 10. A very useful keyboard shortcut is Ctrl or Command plus Backtick. This is also sometimes called the backquote. It is the one with the tilde key. So Ctrl or Command plus Backtick reveals every property for the selected layers. And so one of the fastest ways to collapse all properties of all layers is to select them all with Ctrl or Command plus A and then hit Ctrl or Command plus Backtick. There, nice and tidy. 11. Instead of setting a marker with asterisks and then double clicking it to add a comment or change its color, you can save mountains of time by holding Alt or Option and then hitting asterisks, which will add a marker and automatically open up the dialog box, saving you precious, precious seconds when it really counts. 12. In the Expression Editor, select a portion of code in a single line and hit Ctrl or Command D to duplicate it, and if you select multiple lines, the same Ctrl or Command D shortcut will duplicate the entire line. 13. Again, in the Expression Editor, you can indent multiple lines of code by selecting them and hitting Tab, making the Expression Editor a much friendlier place to be. 14. With the project panel active, you can quickly add a new folder with the mega shortcut Ctrl or Command plus Alt or Option plus Shift plus N. 15. And last, but certainly, certainly, certainly not least, if you need to know the duration between two keyframes instead of doing math, Alt or Option click the two keyframes in succession and the duration between them will be displayed in the info panel. I'm consistently learning new things making these videos, so please leave a comment with what your favorite After Effects tip or trick is, so we can all learn together and eventually discover what's really going on inside this software. And if you want to know some more really practical secrets that After Effects just isn't telling you, you'll want to check out this next video. I'll see you there.